Welcome back to another deep dive with Dr. Cat. This time we will be looking at time series forecasting with simple moving average and weighted moving average. We are going to look at these two techniques and we will be looking at how to calculate them by hand. Here on the screen we have a sample problem showing the sales of Pokemon collector cards. They've been growing steadily for 5 years, and we want to forecast the sixth year. We will be looking at this problem with two different approaches. One, using a simple moving average, and two, we will be using a weighted moving average. A simple moving average is basically looking at the average over time. Let's say, for instance, these numbers are charted. And let's say Y is sales and years for the X-axis. Let's say we start at 450 for the first value. And let's just say hypothetically, we increase about that much, and let's also show one, two, actually, I think I'm going to spread it out a little bit more. One, two, three, four, five. And six. What I've got here is this chart that I want to be able to plot forward some of the points to give the XY coordinate. So if we just treat these as XY coordinate values, we can say at year one, 450, year two is about close to 500, year three, 518. Oops. Here, 4, 563, and year 5, 584. Now, you might be thinking, wow, gee, this looks a great deal like a linear regression problem just based on the scatter plot alone. Because you're looking at, well, gee golly, it's almost like a trend line. Well, it's not causal analysis. We are not saying that the year is going to affect the sales. It's more about over time that we're looking at, where the average perhaps can tell us a way to forecast the values for subsequent years. So if we were to look only at a two-year average, we would be looking at perhaps we'd be looking at just 1 and 2 to get 3. If we were looking at the 2 years to get 4, we could look at 2 and 3 to get 4. And so forth, so on, because that would be the pattern in order to calculate for future years. So with this pattern, we would be able to calculate 6 using 4 and 5. And now I'm going to use my calculator as shown on screen to calculate those two numbers. So we have 4 and 5, 563 plus 584 equals divided by 2 is equal to 573.5. So that would be very much like an average if we take 2 years into consideration, which would end up about here-ish. Now, instead of looking at a 2-year, we're going to look at a 3-year for our problem. So let's change colors now. And we're going to be looking at a 3-year average for each time we want to calculate for the following year and so forth, All right, so to calculate for year six, we're gonna have to need the 3 months right before. Anyway, so this is how we would get a difference between, like, the different time periods can give different numbers. So let's maybe try now, and we're still using a simple moving average. So for this simple moving average, let's calculate. Now the formula to calculate the simple moving average is for the time period you're looking at. You're looking at the actual value plus the value before, prior to that. And because we're going to just use for our purposes a three time period calculation, we'll just have t minus 1 and t minus 2 because we're starting at t plus 1. And then we'll just divide by the number of elements that we're looking at. So here, if we were to use actual variables, we would have 584 plus 563. And this is because we're trying to calculate for year 6. And then we can divide by the number of elements, which is 3. So let's do that quick calculation. 584 plus 563 plus 518, which is 1665 divided by 3, which comes out to 555. So this would be the three-year simple moving average. And let's plot that on the chart to get a sense of where that might be. So 555 is kind of close to here. So the three-year is going to be a little bit different. Why? Because it's taking into consideration a much lower, right? So you see how this halfway point is kind of where that one is, whereas this whole distance is incorporating all of this into here. And I should have used a different color for the two-year. For 2 year, we're calculating that difference, whereas 3 years, we're looking at a much different range and different values. Now, weighted moving average is where we take into consideration weights for the different time periods. Now, we're now saying it matters, you know, how recent numbers affect our calculation. So then if, say, for instance, we're calculating year six and we want a two-year time period, and let's say just we are doing a simple way of calculating, we'll go from, I don't know, last year, we'll have weight of 2, and then for 1 year before that, prior 2 years ago, maybe we'll have 1. So now the formula for this is going to look a little bit different, because with the simple moving average, we don't take into consider weights at all. Whereas with the weighted moving average, we do take into the weights, and I will show you how we take that into consideration. So instead of just looking at that, for each time period that we're looking at, let's say year six, we want to take into consideration weight for that time period, the previous one, which for us would be the last year, and then the weight before that. So for us would be 2 and then 1, and then it would be the value for that year, and then over n. So in our hypothetical situation, we would have 2 times 584 plus 1 times 563. And then now, actually, I wrote the wrong thing here. We don't want over n. And now this, let's explain why. So instead of looking at just two elements now, we're saying we need to give higher proportion to the loss here. So we're saying 3. So it's almost like saying we are saying the, I'm sorry, instead of saying we have for 2 years, like, let's say this is the one we're calculating at year 6, last year, 2 years ago. Okay, this would be the simple. But for the weighted, we can't do the same because we're almost saying, like, these correspond like that, right? And we're calculating the final one. No, instead we're saying we're giving more weight to the more recent one. So what it ends up being, we have to calculate the total weights. So this is the sum of weights. And then in our formula, we're going to be using that number, sum of weights. All right, so now our formula here is going to be over 3, not 2, but 3. Let's calculate that. So 2 times 584 equals 1168 plus 563 577. So this is if it were 2 year weighted moving average. Now let's say hypothetically the problem gave us a 3 year moving average to calculate from. So instead of just 2 years, we're going to look at 3 years, and our formula is going to grow to accommodate for the third year. So here we have for the weighted 3 year. Let me try to write that a little neater. So we're still calculating year 6, but now we're going to be looking at the last 3 years. And then we're going to look at the sum of weights. And if we take a very simple 3, 2, 1 as the weights, then it would be sum of 3 plus 2 plus 1. Which would then equal 6, right? So let's try that. Actually, let's try with the grain. Let's try weights with 3, 2, and 1. And, you know, hypothetically, we could have 1, half, 0, or some sort of random different, right? The problem that you're going to be given is going to tell you the weights, at least for this class. So you can just assume that you are given this number. So this would correspond to last year, the year before, 2 years ago. And 3 years ago. So the sum would be 3 plus 2 plus 1, which equals 6. Okay, Okay, so moving forward, now let's try filling in this formula with the values. We have 5, 8, 4. Let me try that again. We have 3 for the weight times 5, 8, 4. We have 2. I didn't mean to write a T. 2 times 5, 6, 3 plus 1 times 5, 18. Over 6. Remember, we want to divide by the number of weights, not by the number of elements. So let's now calculate this formula. So let's clear everything, and we have 3 times 585, 1755, plus 2 times 563. Plus 518 equals 1644. Nope, that was not right. Three, three, nine, nine over six. Five, 66. 0.5. So you see, it's not quite as low as the simple moving average when we did 3 year. So this figure compared to the simple moving average is a little bit higher. Why? Because we give a little more weight to the more recent time periods. So now, just to summarize what we found, a two-year average is going to give you a little bit higher value. Simple moving average. So going back to simple moving average, a two-year is going to give you a higher number than the three-year, because the 3 years ago, it was much lower. Whereas now the weighted moving average, you're going to have 577, which is much higher. Right, because instead of here, you are now a little bit higher with more weight on the more recent. And then 3 years also higher because you're weighing it more heavily on the more recent. Right, so those are a couple of calculations that we've made in order to calculate both simple and moving average. Simple and weighted moving average. So the two formulas to be aware of is that the weighted versions have the weights, and the simple ones do not have the weights. And that was a video comparing simple moving average to weighted moving average using a calculator to calculate these figures by hand. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe. Please let me know what sort of videos that you are interested in, and I will try to, anyway, I'll just stop.